Hello everyone, welcome to the next lecture on the statistics. Today we will discuss about the regression analysis. Myself Dr. Ghar, working in the School of Mathematics, Thapar Institute, India. Contact me if you feel any doubt, either of my email ID. So what we have discussed so far is that we have discussed the Karl-Pearson coefficient of the correlation, which is defined by this equation, and this is examined only for the degree of the correlationship between the two variables. Or you can say it measures how the two variables are close in a given period of the time. So, but this correlation coefficient will not be analyzed or will not be estimated or predict the value of the another variable. Like here, if you have the sum two x and y variables are there. So if I give the value of the x as 43, what will be the value of the y, corresponding value of the y, that is not predicted with the help of the correlation coefficient. So that's why this only measures the how the two variables are closeness to each other. So in order to estimate and predict the value, there is a technique, statistical technique, which is called as the regression analysis. So this regression analysis is used or technique to estimate or to predict one of the variables when the other known values are given. Make sure that this regression analysis is firstly introduced in 1877 by Sir Francis Galton. What is the definition of the regression and the regression analysis? Regression, it is the measure of the average relationship between the two or more variables in terms of the original unit. While the analysis, it is used to establish the nature of the relationship between the variables and provide the mechanism for predicting or estimating, or you can say the forecasting are there. So this regression analysis is used very much in the time series, you can say, also in the forecasting purpose, as well as in the any of the curve fitting are there. So what are the classification of the regression analysis are there? So it is basically divided into the two category. One is based on the change in the proportion. Second is the number of the change with the help of the number of the variables. Under the category of this change in proportion, they are again discretized as the linear or the non-linear. While in the case of the number of the variables, it are discretized into the three portion. One is the simple, second is the partial, and third one is the multiple. So we will describe each all these five models in this presentation is there. What is a general regression curve or the model is there? So any of the in the mathematics, you can define the regression analysis model as like this way. What is the f is there? F is the of the any of the function. F may be the linear function, it may be exponential function, you can say, it may be of the logarithm functions and so on. So y is here is called as the, sorry, this is y is called as the dependent variable, and here x is called as the independent variable are there. Epsilon is called as the error term, and beta is known as the unknown parameter. So if you write this equation as say beta 0 plus beta 1 of xi, that is a linear. So this beta is nothing but the unknown parameters. Also, you can say the goal of this function, what is the goal of this function is, you have to find a function, appropriate function, maybe the linear or the non-linear or exponential, that may closely fit about the given information. How we can achieve them? We will see that. So before that, we will firstly describe what is this epsilon is there. So this epsilon is called as the error term or called as the error variable. So what are the features of the epsilon i's? We have the three different features. First one is the nature of this epsilon I is a random variable. So once it's a random variable, so it follows the it follows the normal distribution with the mean 0 and the variance sigma square. That is, a mean is 0. Variance is sigma square. So the property of epsilon I is normally distributed. On the other hand, what will happen if epsilon is my 0? So what means without epsilon, that is if epsilon is 0, then we can say for the each pair, that is whether the x1, y1, x2, y2, that will fall exactly on the curve. It means if you have these informations are there, so if you try to draw the curve, this is my curve, this is f of xi and beta. So since this line does not pass through this point, so it means epsilon is my non-zero. But what is the meaning of this epsilon is zero? It means all those points are strictly lies on this curve, and it is called as the true regression curve. On the other hand, if it is a non-zero, then it can be fall either the below, depending upon that whether this epsilon is less than zero, or it's four lines above of them when it's greater than zero. Like here, you can see if you have some points are there, and if I draw this, so these all points are lies above of this epsilon will be greater than zero. So we call as the above the graph. So we call as the that is above of the true regression line. So the inclusion of this. Now we will describe what is the, based on this generalized model that is xi and beta, we will assign this property, that is based on this function fi, f, we will define the linear and nonlinear. Like here, so what will happen if this relation is called as the linear, when it will be the linear, that is when you can say when the dependent variable, what is the dependent variable, is my yi, this is my dependent variable, and xi is my independent variable. What is the meaning of that is, when the dependent variable is moved in the fixed proportion of the independent variable. What is the meaning of that? So whatever the xi's are moving, yi are also moving with the help of the fixed proportion. That is called as the linear regression, or it is also called as the simple linear regression model. So when it is moving the fixed proportion, so if you plot the graph, it will be a straight line. So also, once it will be the linear model, so you can write this linear model as of this. So this function is called as a linear, which is denoted like here. So here beta is the unknown parameter. So how many unknown parameters I have taken is 2. Also, you can define the linear equation like this way. So that's depending upon you, whether you want to this. This is also very linear. Now, where a and b are known as the regression parameters, epsilon I is called as the residual term or called as the error, xi is called as the independent variable, y is called as the dependent variable. All of you know that if your equation is a plus bx, so what is the x is? This is my independent variable, and what is the y is? Y is dependent on the x. So x, y is my dependent. The same thing for here, y is here. Also, if you define, if you interchange the role of the x and y like here, you can also, what is the meaning of this a is? As you know that if you draw the graph, what is the meaning of that? So whenever this point, this is my a, that is the intercept, and b is nothing but my slope of the regression line. Also, if you want to define like here, if you consider xi, yi is my independent variable, and xi is my dependent variable, then we could call as the regression of x on y. That is, we can define like here, this is yi comma beta plus epsilon I. Here, this yi is called as my independent variable, xi is called as dependent variable, or you can say xi is a plus, so xi is dependent on yi. That is, epsilon is called as the residue, a and b are again the regression parameters, xi is called as the dependent, yi is my independent variable. Now, what will happen if this function is a nonlinear? Nonlinear, it may be like of this, say, like a e of bx, that's a nonlinear function, like a and b are the unknown parameters. Also, it can be like of this log of b raised to power x, it may be the nonlinear, or it may be like of here a plus bx plus cx square. So it is a quadratic equations are there, and so on. So whenever, what is the definition of this nonlinear is, when the dependent variable does not changes as a fixed value or fixed proportion for the independent variable, means whenever x you have changed, whenever you have changed the value of the x, it will not be vary as a fixed proportion, it may vary as a curve are there. So that is, you can say when you plot on the graph, it would be a curve instead of the straight line. So this nonlinear regression is also called as the curve linear regression model. Now, next part is that how we can classify the number of the variables, that is simple, partial, and the multiple. So as the name suggests, simple, it means when you consider the model with only the two variables, like this, if you consider the regression model as a plus bx plus of epsilon, that is with the help of only x and y. That is when only two variables are studied. So you can consider as a xi and yi are there. On the other hand, the partial regression is when you consider more than the two variable, like here. If you consider like a plus b x1, y plus c z1 plus epsilon. So this is, I call as the I. So this is I here. So what is the meaning of that is, this function is, what is that? This is nothing but my xi, zi and the beta. Here x and z both are my independent variable and y is my dependent variable on x and the z. So why we call as the partials? In order to analyze the regression, we will fix any of the one variable. So we can consider regression between yi and xi by fixing zi's, or you can say the relation between yi and zi by fixing xi. So that's why this is called as the partial. That is, whenever you fix one of the whenever you want to find the relation between the two variables by fixing the other variable as a constant. On the other hand, what is a multiple regression is when you consider more than the two variables at simultaneously. So for example, if you are studying the growth of the wheat, so this is relative to the fertilizer, I call as the xi's. Hybrid seeds, we call as the zi's. Irrigation, we call as the pi's, and so on. And I call as the production of the wheat is yi. So you want to be find a relation of this production of the wheat depending upon the fertilizers, hybrid seeds and the irrigations are there, and many more are there. So that is called as the multiple regression model. Now, since we have the two, either we have the x as my independent variable and y as my dependent variable, else you may have x as my dependent variable and y is my independent variable. So in this case, your equation will be x is a plus by, and in this case your equation will be y is dependent on the x. So it means you have the two regression lines. One is the y on x, this is called as the y on x, and this is called as the x on y. So now we will discuss about that. So the regression line is a graphical technique which shows the relationship between the x and y. That is, one is the dependent and other is independent, like here you can see in this graph. So this graph will represents that, this graph will show the average relationship between the two variables. So that's why this line is also called as average lines or line of the average. Also, this is called as the estimating lines. Why? Because it gives the estimated values of the dependent variable. So if my line is here, so this y is my dependent variable and this x is my independent. So your target is to estimate the value of y based on this independent variable. Why we call as the estimate? Because there is a term of the epsilon I as a error. So that's why, since it will give the average estimated value of the dependent variable y for the given value of the x, that is corresponding to this. So that's why this is called as the estimated lines. Now, since we have the two estimated lines are there, so suppose this green dots are my actual data. Like say, if you have this information x and y, so if you plot this graph, if you plot these values are there, and it is denoted as a dotted by green color in here. And once you will draw this graph, so you can see this line has it is not the accurate one. So it means this portion, this is the error. Similarly for this one is called as the error. Similarly for this red line, this one is called as the error. So your target is to find the two regression lines here. One is the x on y. X on y means x is my dependent variable and y is my independent variable. So how you define that? X is dependent, a plus by, which shows the variation in the values of the x when you change the values of the y, like here. On the other hand, the second line is y on x. Y is my dependent and x is my independent. So now, once you are talking about these two lines, x on y and y on x, your target is to identify these unknowns value of the a and b. But what will happen if these two lines are coincides? That is, if these two lines are same, what is the meaning of that? The correlation coefficient is minus 1 to plus 1. Now, the objective of these regression lines is to, this blue line and the red lines are my regression lines, and your objective is to draw the line in such a way which has fit these green dots are there, that is fitting the given information. So how you can do that? For this, we need to find these unknown parameters A and B. How we can find the unknown parameters? That's most common thing is that we will estimate the parameters A and B by using method of least square. That is, what is the method of least square is, if you have this, our objective is to find the curve which has the best fit. Like here, if I consider this blue line firstly, you can consider this error as either as a vertically, or you can consider as a perpendicular. So you can take as a either as a error as a vertical, this is my error. Again, if you consider as a vertical, this is my vertical error, so this is called as the again error. But it is quite obvious that the vertical offset will almost give the minimization as compared to the perpendicular. So what we can do that, how we can compute the parameters A and B, or we can also call as the regression parameters. How we can do that? So I consider for the Y on X. Similarly, we can consider X on Y. So this is a line for the A plus BX. What is the value of this R there? So our target is to estimate the values R there. So that is I call as Y of E. And my target is to find which has the minimum error. So by using the principle of the least square, we target is to minimize the error, that is Y minus YE. So I can substitute the value here. What is the rule for the minimization is? That is the partial derivative of A and B with respect to 0, because the unknowns are A and B. So once you will derivative this with respect to A, you will get this, because look at that, if you take 2 as outside, this is Y minus A minus BX. What is the coefficient of A is? Minus 1. So you can see like here. Similarly, with respect to B, what is the coefficient is XR. So once you will simplify here, it will be 2 will be 0. You can write here. Now, once you will open this bracket, what will happen? This is summation Y. This is summation of A, that is N of A. B is constant, so it can be written outside here. Similarly, for the second line, this is XY. A is outside, constant value, minus B is outside, is X square. So you can write all those negative terms on the right hand side. These are called as the normal equations. So I will tell you how you can remember that. That is for Y on X, how you can remember these equations are there easily. So you can see how many unknowns are there, A and B. What is the coefficient of the A? That is a 1. What is the coefficient of A, X, B is X. So now, what is the meaning of this is, you can multiply this equation by 1. So what is the equation? Becomes A plus BX. Now you can multiply this equation by X. What is that? This is XY. This is AX plus BX square. Now once you are multiplied their coefficient, now put up as the summation on each term. So you can see what will happen. This is now my Y. This is the constant value, so I can write as NA, B is outside, and so on. Similarly, you can define with respect to the X on Y. You can see what is the coefficient of the A is now 1. Coefficient of B is my Y. So multiply 1, so you will get this equation. Now if you multiply this by Y, so this becomes AY plus BY square. And then put as a summation, you will get this. So these two equations are called as the normal equations. So once you will solve them, you will get the A and B. So also there is a point of the intersection in the graph. So that point of intersection is called as the mean of the series X and mean of the series Y. Now how you find the regression coefficient? That is, regression coefficient is represent the slope of the lines. So what is the meaning of that? We have these two lines, A plus BX and A plus BY. What is the slope of this line is? B. So we call as this is the line of the Y on X. So I call as the regression coefficient is my B Y on X. So call as the B Y on X. Similarly for here, this is the X on Y. The corresponding slope is my B. So we call as the B X Y is my regression coefficient. So as you know, the correlation coefficient is denoted by small r, while the regression coefficient is denoted by B Y X and B X Y X Y. This is the line corresponding to the x on y. This is the coefficient, that is the slope corresponding to the y on x. How you can estimate the value of the bx and what is the slope is? As we know, this is a regression equation. Now you can simplify them. How you can simplify them? You can eliminate the value of a, you can multiply them with the summation of the x and here as a n, and once you will subtract them, you will get this expression. Now, once you will be here, you can simplify them. You can divide numerator and denominator by n square. You will get this expression. Can you identify that? What is that? This is nothing but my expected value of xy. This is x and so on. So what is that portion? This is nothing but my covariance. And this is nothing but my variance. Also, you can know that what is the value of the correlation coefficient is. This is my sigma x of sigma y. Now, if you substitute here, what will happen? This is r sigma x sigma y. What is the variance of x is? Sigma x square. So, 1 sigma x square will be cancelled out. So, that right expression is y upon x is there. That is regression coefficient. So, this is a regression coefficient of y on x here. Similarly, you can derive them as a x on y. How you can remember that? I will tell you the shortcut. That is r. This is y on x. So, this is y on x. Similarly, on x on y means, this is wrong. This is x on y. This is x on y. That x upon y. Now, we can see one example how you can solve them. Suppose this is a given information to you. This is the Carl-Pearson coefficient. This is r is 0.4. You have to find the regression lines, correlation, regression coefficient and so on. So regression lines. So we are talking about the x on y as well as y on x. So let's start with the y on x. So that is y minus y bar is because our target is to find this. This is the point, intersection point is here. So how you can write this line, y is equal to a plus bx. So this is a point which is, that's a 1 point form, y minus y bar is slope. This is the line y on x here. You have the value of the y bar, that's a mean, this is a 40. You can substitute here. This is y minus 40. Byx is not given to you. What is the x bar is? Physics marks mean is 30. Now, how you can find the value of the byx? So byx is r, y on x. You have the value of the r, you have the standard deviation of the y, 20, you have the value of the x here, you can substitute as a 0.8. Now you can substitute this value in this, you will get the right answer is. This is the line of the y on x. Similarly, you can find the regression line of x on y, here b xy will be there. You can substitute the value of the x bar here, y bar is my 40, you can calculate this value here also. This is my 10 upon 20. So once you will calculate all these values, you can substitute here, you will get this line of regression. So what is the regression coefficient is there? So byx, that is a 0.8, and the 0.2 are the regression coefficient. Now look at this third and fourth part. You have to find the value of y when x is 40. So either you can substitute in this or in this. So the question arises here. You have to find the value of y. It means this is my dependent, and x is 40 is given to you, it means this is my independent variable. So which thing is my this is y is dependent, x is independent. So your target is to find y on x. So this is the line y on x. So you have to substitute x as a 40 in here. On the other hand, in this case, this is my dependent one, y is 20 is given to you, that's independent, that is x on y. So you have to substitute y as here, you will get these two results are there. This is the equation when you substitute here, this is the value you can substitute here. So this is the basic overview about this regression analysis are there. We will see some more examples related to the coefficients and the line in our next class. Till then, you can simply follow this link for finding the more updated video. Best of luck, students. Happy learning.